Okay, so we're recording. We're here with Paul Neelands, and we're discussing the power electronics construction set. So, just like we're working on the tractor construction set, where we're using many multipurpose modules such as power cubes, frames, modular wheel units, modular interconnections, we can apply similar topics to electronics, where we have a number of modules that we can mix and match. And that can create any kind of power electronic device from a welder to a plasma cutter to an induction furnace and many others. So we'd like to approach the electronics, the power electronics, as a construction set, just like we do for mechanical issues. And here we've got our session here with Paul to help us get there. So what we have here is a document that's anyone can edit. So I'm sharing this with you, Paul.
Okay.
So this document is open. So if you look into your text box there, you can click in there, and then we can start. So how should we approach this? I think we might want to talk about in the formal design process, we start with our need, and that's the requirements, and then maybe start the discussion like that. But the requirements are to come up with a basic. Let me know when you've gotten in there. Can you click on that? Can you see there's a if you click on is your chat window open? To do that, is it?
I'm not sure what I'm supposed to do here.
Yeah, so on the Google Hangout, if you go. Scroll to the left-hand side, a black bar should come up, and there's a blue box on top that says chat. If you click on that, you should open up the chat window. If you scroll your mouse
I
towards
see
the
it.
left.
Yeah, I see thing my chat.
Okay, and in the chat, I just sent you a link. Did you see that link?
Okay, I see the link. I have it.
Okay, so and just for the people who are going to listen to this, so Paul Neelands, you have had a career in electronics design, and I think that was focusing on power electronics, like welders and other things. Can you just summarize your background in the field?
I've done a number of welders. I've done three welders.
These are commercially
All high
produced ones.
frequency. Yeah.
Yep.
I've also done a number of power supplies. Going up to about 1 kilowatts. They're all switchable power supplies.
For what applications were they used in?
It's for charging the electrical grid. For testing, if you connect a substation to the electrical grid, you need that it's going to work.
Yeah, electrical grid applications. On the so is that like on the megawatt scale?
No, it was quite small. It was 5 kilowatt.
5 kilowatt scale?
And it could simulate things like a lightning strike onto a power line or a failure transformer. It would inject transients into a substation that was disconnected. So this connected, and have two substations connected to it, and you inject transient events into it, and it would connect the other substation, and it might exercise its protective equipment.
Yeah.
The transient power was quite high. It was much higher than the continuous reading, which was 5 kilowatts.
Uh-huh. The transient power was much higher than the 5 kilowatts?
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Any other electronics projects? Is this... And this...
Mostly it's all switch mode and our computers. I've this microprocessor stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And besides the electronics, that should be what mostly with embedded microprocessors.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So you have talked to us before about, we began a discussion, this was a couple of, 2 or 3 years ago now, regarding the basic building blocks of a many power electronic devices. We have a, actually I looked at your log, which is Paul log on the wiki, and we have old diagrams of, we started on a welder plasma cutter, so I'll just make a link to that document.
I had to look at that in preparation for this.
Yeah. So I'm going to put an old OSC work link on that front page there for your reference, so you can click on that. Yeah. Which was plasma cutter welder. Welder conceptual design. So today maybe we can go back a little bit. Like in that diagram, we actually went through a lot of we were talking about the kind of the what's the input, like AC, etc. Adding modules on top of that, such that you can get plasma cutter, inverter, even a Hall cell, a welder. And so we talked about how an induction furnace could be a different variation of that. But I think what we want to do is just go to the basic modules, just kind of like start back again, and maybe, Paul, maybe you can feedback on the best approach to do this, but perhaps it's about saying we have an input at some frequency, some voltage, and some current, and then we're trying to get an output at another frequency, amplitude, and amperage. So I think maybe it'll be useful. Go ahead.
Another area, I noticed you have one of your machines.
Uh-huh.
Another use of power electronics is variable speed electric motors.
Yeah. Right. Variable speed electric motors.